Hello and welcome to Jackall Digital. I'm Simon, and today I'll be showing you how you can easily make a cool image like this. I was inspired by a TV series called Killjoys, which I also have down here. And this is the art style that they introduced in the TV series. So how we can do this easily? Let's find out. Now I will be doing this in Adobe Illustrator. And the first thing that we need is an image. I already have one, so I can get down to business. Now I'll use this image to post it to Instagram, so I can go to the artboard and set the size. And this is the image size that posts in Instagram are 1080 pixels by 1350 pixels. But because the image is too big, I have to resize it. So I'll just resize it to the height and position it how I like it. And now that you have our image set up, you have to decide on a color palette. I'll be using the Killjoys color palette, but you can use whatever you want, and you can even make your own. As far as the image goes, for best results, you want your face to be lit up. In this case, I am not. I have dark eyes and also dark around the mouth. So if you want something to pop out, be sure that your face is lit up properly. So the first step that we have to do now is select the image. We could use this image trace right here, but we do want to customize it a little bit. So you will go into Window and click on the image trace. This gives us some options and do also have advanced. Now that image trace is open, we go into shades of gray, and by default we have 50 shades of gray, no pun intended. Now, depending on the image size, this process might take a while. So I have played a little bit with the settings. I decided to go with 2 grays, minimum pads and corners, and maximum noise, but in my case it didn't make any difference. In your case, you may get extra details if you want them with max noise. The fewer the pads you have, the smoother the line will be. The more pads you have, the more jagged the line will be. Also, if you have less corners, it will be smoother. And if you have more of them, you will have also more jagged lines. And this is how it looks when you have everything to minimum. I also decided to go with less grays because I get this weird effect, which, I don't know, I'll turn it into clone, probably. Or an animal, I don't know, it looks like an animal. And now that we have our image, we can close this. Make sure that the image is selected. Go to Object, Expand, make sure that Object and Field are selected, and click OK. So again, make sure the image is selected. And ungroup. But it's still not enough, so we have to repeat this process. Ungroup. Now we're good to go. I'll still leave the whole image at this point because I don't know if I want to reposition anything, because I can still reposition if I want to. And I will now use this Killjoy image. I'll just bring it in and I'll use this for my color palette. You can also use this image, I'll leave a link to it down below, where you can make your own color palette. Now we will mainly use the V shortcut for the selection tool and the I shortcut for the eyedropper tool. We will basically be doing this, but because I don't want to always go to the picture with the eyedropper tool, I'll show you a quick way how you can make a bigger color palette that is closer to your hands. So you go to the line segment tool, hold down the left mouse button and click the rectangular grid tool. Now click and drag, and while holding the left mouse button, you can use the arrow keys. You can increase and decrease the number of squares that you can have. You can make more of them so you don't have to repeat this process, and once you're happy, just release it. Then go to the rectangle tool and make a rectangle over this and make sure you have some fill color. You can have any color you want, but I'll go with white since it's neutral. Then select both elements go to Pathfinder. If you don't have it, you can go to Window and Pathfinder and select the divide. Then you have to ungroup this, and you now have separate squares, and you can just remove the outside. So now I can select, let's say I'll start with the face, maybe with the direct shades like this. No, that is quite a palette. I could definitely go with more colors, but I think this is quite enough. So now I will make the same process as I did with this palette by coloring this side. The only difference is that I can choose the same shades of gray with shift and color it at once. And also, if it's something connected, be it either grass for body part or maybe house, sky, it's wise that you then group up the same shades of color, so if you need to change them later on, you can do that easily. And to group them up, you just press Ctrl G like this. So if now I select this, it's connected, and I'll just undo. Or you can select them and click anywhere with right click and choose group, and it will do the same. Okay, and now I will speed up this process, and I'll see you in a bit. Now I am done. It took me a little bit of time because I had the tree in the background and I didn't want to leave it in shades of gray. And now I'll just group everything up. Select the line toward it because I think I moved it a little bit. Or maybe not, I don't know. Or maybe it's a little bit, yeah, it's a little bit bigger. But that's okay. Export for screens. Artboards. It's going to export as PNG. Okay. Images. And there we have it, our very own image in the style of Killjoys. If you like this video, like and subscribe. Leave a comment. Until next time, Jackals. Keep it digital.